How do you fold a circle into 10 equal parts so that each angle is 36 degrees? Now take a circle with a diameter of 15 centimeters, double it up and fold the diameter, crease it and mark it with a pen. The value of this diameter would be 32. Now fold at right angles to locate the center. Now this is point 0, the middle is 16 and the top is 32. Now fold the top tip to the center to locate 24. Fold bottom to 24 to locate 12. Now fold the top to this to locate 27. And finally bisect this, and this line would be 11 from the center. Once again fold this diameter, fold the and mark it with dotted lines, fold the right tip of this diameter to the center and fold both the tips. This will locate point P, which is important for our purpose. Mark it with dotted line, and the height would be 11 by 32 and the base would be 8 by 32. Now the angle P to the center and the right would be 54 degrees. Now tan inverse 11 by 8 is roughly 53 degrees and 97 seconds, or roughly 54 degrees. So angle PO right would be 54 degrees. Now mark this diameter. Now, once again, extend the hypotenuse of the triangle to get the second point. Now, once you've got these reference points, you can always bisect these sectors. This is bisecting to get the midpoints. And similarly, bisect the other sectors to divide the circle into 10 equal parts, and each internal angle would be 36 degrees. And every time that you crease it, you mark the lines with the pen so that they are visible. So now you can see that this is divided into 10 parts, and you name them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, and each sector is 36 degrees. Now we're going to just mark what was 54 degrees, angle P to the center, and the right side is, this is the angle which is 54 degrees, and its complementary angle is 36 degrees. Have fun dividing a circle into 10 equal sectors.